Psychological Explorations with Dr. Michael Axelman and Daniela. We continue our musical psychology and our exploration of the psychological positions, exploring the autistic contiguous position put forth by Thomas Ogden, the most primitive and the position that dominates life after birth and the weeks and month or two after, where it's dominating, and then it continues throughout the life course as we move in and out of the autistic position, but hopefully not under such dominance. We explore a song today, Whispering Pines, which you've heard a bit of, from the 1969 Brown album, The Band. You'll see Richard Manuel there on the far left and Robbie Robertson on the far right, the songwriters. Richard Manuel came up with the idea, and he's the vocalist. It's a song that really is unusual in that it's not blues, it's not folk, it's a song that really exists in this liminal space of dissociation, of kind of desire unfulfilled, but the desire is never really clear. It's just this pushing towards contact that's never realized. Let's take a look now at the positions, and I will let you know that Richard Manuel suicided in the mid-80s, and he suffered terribly from mental illness throughout his life. Apparently started drinking heavily as a 9-year-old. So these positions, they're kind of ways of orienting in the world, ways of being, ways of connecting. And there's a sequence, a development over time that one is able to hopefully move towards the depressive position. We're talking today about the autistic contiguous position, which is sensory dominated, pre-symbolic mode of generating experience. Anxiety in this mode consists of an unspeakable terror of the dissolution of boundedness. And this song really speaks to this notion of the dissolution of boundedness. We begin with, right, there's not a person, there's just fragments that could coalesce into a person. And one of these fragments kind of lands on a sensory surface, a parent, a warm body. And through that initial touch and sensation, a boundary is created that over time creates a perimeter, and that perimeter becomes the emergent self. This song is describing a part of experience prior to that self having a perimeter, and it is into that realm of unspeakable terror. It really can't be talked about because there's no person yet who has coalesced who can record this experience. So this is a person who has not yet actualized, and we have a human moving towards personhood. In the paranoid schizoid place, the person is established in a very fragile way as a part object, and interacts with others in the world as part objects, not whole people. And the wholeness of the person isn't reached until the depressive position. The autistic contiguous position discussed by Ogden, the psychological organization generating the most primitive state of being, which has a period of primacy earlier than the paranoid, schizoid, and depressive positions as described by Klein, yet coexists dialectically with these other positions from the beginning of psychological life. Ogden extends the concept of psychological positions or organizations to include this most primitive aspect, and it's pre-symbolic in that all of these songs and music and poetry, right, is in the world of symbolism. So in some ways we can't really capture this state through symbols in that it is a pre-symbolic one. It's a specific mode of attributing meaning to experience in which raw sensory data are ordered by means of forming pre-symbolic connections, sensory contact, right, between sensory impressions that come to constitute bounded surfaces. And this is the contiguous aspect, right, the part of the human connecting to the part of another surface. Pre-symbolic sensation dominated experience. So the experience of sensation at the skin surface, sensory boundary, that are the principal media for the creation of psychological meaning. Touching over time generates the sense of a bounded sensory surface on which one's experience occurs. The autistic continuous mode is a sensory-dominated pre-symbolic mode of generating experience, which provides a good measure of the boundedness and the beginnings of the sense of the place where one's experience occurs. Anxiety in this mode consists of the unspeakable terror of the dissolution of the boundedness, resulting in feelings of leaking, falling, or dissolving into endless, shapeless space. And we'll get a feel of this as we move into this song. Here in the first verse, we have the hints at the failed process of internalizing the object, the one star that's just enough to get inside. This internalization, though, never completes, and we wait until it all goes round and round and round in these dissociative cycles, seeking sensory boundedness but not finding it.
Thank you.
dissociation from self and other, and this inability to make connection through the senses just dominates the end of this song. The drifting in the days, the haze, the cold, cold sun, the empty house. Again, these hints at the failed internalization of the object, leaving the infant toddler to just drift without any establishment of boundedness. We'll end today with an opportunity to hear the song all the way through now that we've had a chance to touch on some of the key touch points. If you would like to explore this concept further, we have a full presentation on the Autistic Contiguous Position by Ogden. Thank you for joining us, and yes, one more time here with Richard Manuel and the band and Whispering Pines.
Just enough.